Beautiful people around the world, welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm so happy to see you. Welcome to the Loud Project charity fundraiser. I'm so happy to see you guys. Allow me to introduce myself. Where are my manners? Hi guys, I'm your girl Daddy Sims, and I'm gonna be your official host for today's program. And man, it's exciting to be able to connect with people around the entire world right now. It's just out of this world. Anyways, guys, we are here today to celebrate charity, to fundraise, and of course to talk about the pandemic. That's something I really don't want to do, but we do have to address it. Everyone around the world knows that there has been an ongoing COVID-19 pandemic that has affected so many things that's going on in the world right now. I mean, we're talking about schools, businesses, Everything is just really messed up right now. Everything's just a mess. I mean, life was normal until it wasn't. And now, here in Uganda, we're trying to find our new normal of, you know, continuing life amidst this pandemic. Now, this pandemic has greatly affected children and the education system. So many kids cannot go back to school because their parents can't afford the tuition fees and, of course, you know, scholastic materials, books, pens, and all that stuff. The economy is just genuinely really bad in Uganda, and people are keeping their heads barely above water for survival. So the Loud Project has come up with a way to kind of help finance that and aid kids, and at least help kids manage to go through their education. And bruvs, we're really just trying to do the most that we can, which is why you guys have really done an amazing job by buying tickets and supporting it. Now, of course, we're gonna just dive right into it, and we're gonna have people share their success stories for the next 1 hour about COVID and how they have been impacted, affected, and how they're dealing with this pandemic. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're gonna dive right into it. Let's get it.
Distance learning has exposed deep inequalities in the education system, which could intensify in a post-pandemic world. Digital solutions are efficient based on access to devices and connectivity, digital literacy on parts of the teacher, parents, and student. While digital access and literacy is growing across the global South, distance learning approaches rely exclusively on tech, deepening inequality as well-off children connect and continue their studies and more vulnerable students fall behind. Eastern Uganda is one of the most impoverished places in the region, with social challenges ranging from period poverty, teenage and child marriages, high levels of illiteracy, to mention but a few. A group of university students saw these gaps and decided to use their student association to battle these issues, with education being a key factor. They've managed to empower HIV-positive orphan children by enrolling them into school, providing the basic education requirements, and focusing on adolescent orphan girls by empowering them with life skills and information to cope with their HIV status and other sexual reproductive health issues.
This first song is called Soul Searcher, an original. A little backstory. My freshman year at college, I lived in one dorm room with three other girls. Okay. So, of course, I wrote this in the bathroom to escape. It goes like this. I'm a soul searcher, looking through a lens, yet I'm keeping my eyes closed. I'm a heart seeker, but what I do to yours is out of my control. Picture in a frame to leave it. once again, a simplified reminder. I sometimes wonder if we are the same. We all smile through the pain. Life is getting harder. I'm
We first met each other in January 2020 on a solo volunteer trip to Nairobi, Kenya. We were both at the same homestay and placement school, Star of Wonder. We immediately bonded over our love for Africa and began discussing our goals and interests and how we could help our school. We quickly realised that Star of Wonder needs a lot of support. They were already supporting around 300 children, most of which could not pay their school fees. Despite being unable to pay, Star of Wonder will never turn a child away. A lot of the children are orphans and needed somewhere safe that could provide them food and shelter. We wanted to make an instant difference and teamed together on site, and in a short time we were able to resurface the preschool floor. We also purchased 50 textbooks and bought some school uniforms as well as school supplies. When we returned home, we continued to help out where we could. This led to building new restrooms for the school and also raising money for healthcare bills when one of our young children fell ill. Luckily, she made a full recovery thanks to quick action. COVID hit and we had to continue supporting from afar. From this point, we made a pact to become joint directors of the school and begin supporting the school full time. Our main goal is to continue providing a safe space for children, to shelter them from the brutality of the slum by providing access to education and meals for all. The effect of COVID made things tougher than ever. The school could no longer keep up on rent and was immediately forced off the land by the landlord, losing everything they had. This meant all the classrooms must be rebuilt and located for Star of Wonder to ever reopen. Without Star of Wonder, almost 300 children would no longer have access to education, meals and safety. Food became so scarce in the slum that a stampede broke out by the people in an attempt to receive food rations by the government, resulting in fatalities. We quickly set up a fundraiser in an effort to save the school and successfully raised enough money to rebuild and relocate all of the classrooms, allowing Star of Wonder to reopen. Now the school has recovered from the financial disaster of COVID, our current goal is to get the school recognised as a tax-exempt non-profit in the United States. From there, it is our hope to apply for grants and engage in partnerships to eventually purchase land and permanently relocate out of the slum to a safe environment for the children. We also hope to have a boarding facility on the land for our children to live, as many of them are orphans and cannot safely take care of themselves. For more information and updates on our journey or to continue supporting our school, follow us at Star of Wonder Edu.
I'm Sergeant Patricia, an activist from Chibera Adolescent and Youth Club. I advocate for sexual reproductive health and rights, ending gender-based violence and sanitation. My target group is from the age of 10 years to the age of 25 years, both boys and girls. When we talk of sexual reproductive health and rights, we are talking of menstruation hygiene and management, we talk of family planning, we talk of HIV/AIDS information and services, we talk of ending stigma, and other components. I personally focus more on menstruation hygiene and management, ending gender-based violence, ending stigma around menstruation and HIV/AIDS. My target group is from the age of 10 years to 25 years, both girls and boys. What do? We create awareness through community and school outreaches. Not only that, we also train girls and boys on different livelihood skills, like making reusable sanitary towels, making doormats, making wall hangings, and this helps us to earn a living. And COVID ended our work because we couldn't move from different places to create awareness. Not only that, we couldn't get materials to use on our daily work. But that couldn't stop us. We had to look for another solution. We started making different videos on different information. We started having a small group training them different skills, like making reusable sanitary towels. Not only that, all this we are doing this, but in a way that a girl child goes back to school. The money we collect from sanitary towels or wall hangings or doormats, we keep it and bless a child who is not schooling. That has enabled us to grow and develop deep. Thank you so much.
everybody. My name is Q, and thank you so much for having me perform today. I'm going to be covering a song called Strange by Celeste. So here it goes. Thank you so much, everybody. You can follow me on Facebook or Instagram. My link is somewhere down here. Thank you so much.
With a low livelihood and an economic downturn, families cannot be able to send their children to school, especially in third world countries where household incomes contribute to education. Children end up dropping out, who are faced with problems such as early pregnancies and being exploited at work. Our next activist has created a platform, Menstrual Closet Uganda, that's a safe space for girls to talk about menstruation and all other factors. This is done through activities like community talks, group discussions, and other activities. Allow me to introduce Mercy Sabiti.
Hello, I hope you're doing all right. My name is Mercy Sabiti, and I'm the founder of the Menstrual Closet Uganda. The Menstrual Closet Uganda is an online educational platform by menstruators for menstruators, which is basically aimed at trying to educate anyone who really wants to know, anyone who will pay attention, educating them about periods, about menstruation, what it entails, and all the technicalities, but also all the challenges that come with it. It's something that I decided to start after reading a book on menstruation, and I was like, hold up, these are things that every woman should know. And I guess the education that I was given, which was, I guess they talked about it in sex education, but they didn't even talk about it that much. And I decided, you know, like someone should be telling us why this is happening to our bodies. Someone should be explaining why there are these hormonal imbalances and also things to do with it. So I started to openly have the discussion with even my friends. And I realized that this was not something you could just start talking about. This was something that a lot of people were shy about, not just the boys, but also the women. So I decided that, you know what, let's start something. Let me start like maybe an online page that talks about menstruation. And if someone wants to listen, well, they'll listen. If someone wants to pay attention, well, they'll pay attention. And I think that the goal of this was honestly in the beginning just to educate people that, okay, this happens. These are hacks on how you can wash your period underwear and get it done like so quickly, or like, oh, this is what you can do when you don't have pads, or like, oh my god, did you know there are more sustainable options about that, more sustainable options to menstrual products, and why aren't we supporting brands that are trying to be sustainable and take care of our environment? Honestly, initially that was it, and it was something that it was a quarantine project, and I at the time I knew a friend who knew a friend who was actively involved in menstrual activism. So I got their number, I talked to them, and it became an actual thing. So people started to share their stories, and that's the part that really got me. People started to share really personal stories on their experiences and the practical challenges, the practical difficulties that it creates around the fact that we cannot openly discuss menstruation. So how are people supposed to find solutions to period-related problems when people can't talk about it? How are people supposed to develop maybe medication? How are researchers supposed to get this information if people are not willing to give it? And really, that was the standpoint for why we decided to start. And then we reached out to the period movement, and then became a chapter in Uganda. And we also work with August, both of which are international organizations. And really, like, they've given us a lot of support. The entire COVID experience has been insightful for people who are trying to get smarter, create solutions, like how do we reach out to the community without actually being there. And we have faced a few challenges, but nonetheless, we were able to do two product drives where we actually went out and gave someone products. And and it was a very pleasant experience. We also decided to reach out to actual communities, to actually go out and talk to people and find out how are you experiencing this. And we decided that as a group of friends, we could collect something and then buy menstrual products and go out and distribute them, or like, let's make someone's day, someone who can't afford pads, like let's give them pads for a month. We also decided to reach out to local communities and ask them about their experiences, and then maybe donate a few products and talk to them and give them an educational session on menstruation. And we tried to make sure that these discussions and these outreaches were not just for the women, that they were for both sexes. And we saw how that went, and it went really well. So we actually occasionally also actually go out and give out products. Thank you so much for coming and continue to attend events like this. And a shout out to the Loud Project for allowing us to be part of this. You guys are the real MVPs. Yeah, have fun with the rest of the program.
Thank you.
Hi everybody, I hope that you're doing all well and safe. My name is Noria, I'm based in Morocco, and I've been busy lately with filming contents and highlighting the cultural and music scene in Morocco. Since we all have seen the turnover around the world, some matters such as education and climate change are tackling us from close, so we can't ignore them anymore. Education is fundamental and universal human rights. Societies should make every effort to sustain it, by any means necessary. In this time of disruption, we have seen how difficult it is to ensure the availability of functioning educational institutions and programs, and at acceptable levels of quality. All bodies must commit to ensuring that any retrogression is temporary, truly prompted by emergency conditions, and redressed as soon as that becomes possible, so that the recent decades of progress are not undone and so that the 2020s do not become a decade of lost opportunity. Our next activist runs Through Our Voices, a non-profit organization focusing on education, attainment and retention, especially among rural children through fighting stigma menstruation, gender-based violence and reading initiatives. Through Our Voices was birthed from My Voice podcast, a woman empowerment podcast that shares personal stories, experiences and opinion of youth and adolescents on life-related topics geared towards eradicating education inequality, gender-based violence and mental health stigma. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Lisa Kawoya.
That supports the education retention for rural school-going girls in Uganda through breaking the stigma around menstruation, fighting gender-based violence, as well as conducting fun-filled reading educational activities. Through Our Voices was backed by My Voice podcast, a women empowerment podcast that shares stories, personal stories, experiences, and opinions of youth and adolescents around the world on topics geared around the eradication of gender-based violence, gender inequality, and issues around mental health. Within the pandemic, My Voice podcast was able to organize an advocacy campaign that supported over 100 girls in northern Uganda in a sub-county called Alero. These girls were supported with menstrual hygiene management information, as well as menstrual materials and value-based children's educational books. With that impact, we were able to get over 20 girls were able to come and join the learning clusters that were happening at Ongai Primary School in Alero District. The parents supported and were very happy to let their girls continue learning, even within the pandemic. This time around, we would like to target and have over 500 girls in four communities and help them to train them, give them menstrual hygiene materials as well as value-based educational books in an effort to keep them in school and keep them going. With your support, with just $10, a generous donation, we'll be able to keep a girl and more in school through this period. Thank you very much.
Cause you know I've been loyal. here now, give it way to for this moment.